Another one of our videos explaining how to construct a simple on-site biodegradable toilet waste biodigester using prefabricated slabs. The good news about this video is that I've taken the shot from the top, so I basically call it an aerial view of how to construct a biodigester, and then I've given the details of how to go about it exactly as you want it.
We are meeting the biodigester construction at the point where the slabs has been fixed. Of course, the digging has been done, the settings all have been done, and the slabs have been fixed. Now all the mortar joints have been sealed with mortar, and before then they were held with wire mesh binding wires, and then the pipes has also been put in place. The inlet pipe, you can see, is showing there. The outlet is also there, and then a soak away for the wastewater filtration is also there. And for this particular construction, one digester has already been done at the other side of the house. This is just an add-on for the other side of the property, and that's why we are here, just to finish this work. In this type of construction, what you are looking for is the soil texture. The moment you get the soil texture right, you know half of the work is done. The wastewater is always your biggest problem. So having a point where you can have the water into any soakaway will greatly help with the wastewater management. And that's what you are looking for.
When it comes to labeling parts of the biodigester, what I've always tried to explain is to differentiate between the inlets and then the outlets. In most of the time, the inlet pipe is what comes from the house. The inlet pipes usually are the 4-inch pipes. The inlet pipes can be in several locations of the digester. They can come in at the bigger end, they can come in through the 2-foot side, and they can equally come in from the top, depending on where you are locating the biodigester. And then the inlet pipe is what brings the human waste from the house into the biodigester bed. Your inlet pipe's positioning is key, because that's what leverages the longer use of the biodigester. The inlet pipes gives you the leverage when you do have it up, and the inlet pipes is mostly determined by the position of the pipes that are coming from the house. So it's key when you are positioning the biodigester, the inlet pipes become the most important part of how your biodigester is going to last for you. That's key. The second pipe is the Neshi pipe, or the outlet. And the outlet pipe simply means that this is the pipe that carries the wastewater out of the digester. This is the pipe that carries the black water out of the digester. So that's why most of the time we say it's the Neshi pipe. The Neshi pipe, the difference between the inlet pipe and the Neshi pipe is that the Neshi pipe can be done with any inches. It can be done with different sizes. The pipe, it can be 3 inches, it can be 2 inches, and then of course it can be 4 inches, depending on what you have available to you. But let's say you are doing it and you are using, it's a 4 toilet seat, or it's a 4-bedroom house, and you're having 4 different pipes or 3 different pipes coming into the digester through the inlet, and you are using a 2-inch pipe, then obviously the black water coming out, the space needed will not be enough. So I always suggest you get a bigger pipe. The bigger the pipe, the better to immediately drain the water out of the digester bed. And that's very key for you when it comes to the biodigester construction. Moreover, when you are selling the biodigester, you are also looking at the point whereby you are going to make it airtight. I've always preached this thing. you are holding the mortar joints to make sure that as much as possible, no outside forces prevent your biodigester from doing what it's supposed to do, which is the biodegradation. Anything that happens in the digester is something you can control. You want to control how your biodigester works. And that's why you are sealing it airtight and you are preventing outside forces from not making your digester work perfectly. Another key part of the biodigester that I've also preached is the porous slabs or the pervious concrete. These are usually done from chippings, and the idea is that it helps with the filtration of the wastewater. Yeah, as much as possible, you want the water that goes into the air surface or the water that goes into the soakaway or the water that goes into the drain system to be as clean as possible. So you are using this filtration material to ensure that water that you're draining from the digester is a bit cleaner. We usually do them using chippers, and then we hold them together so that there will be enough spaces for the water just to seep through. In recent times, we've also done this porous slabs or filtration slabs by just having the original slabs done and just putting some holes in them so that when the biodigester bed is on it, the water can equally seep through it, and then it might last a longer time when you are using these slabs as your pervious concrete slabs.
So we have done the screeding of the floor. The idea is you just don't want the wastewater stacked in the digester itself where the biodegradation is going to happen. So you give it a slope, a gradient, and you let the water out. Immediately, it's flushed from the system out into the soakaway. Then perfectly, biodegradation happens after that with the material that you put on the biodigester bed.
I have done some corrections on some biodigesters that I've come to realize the biggest problem that they had was not because of the digester not working well, it was because of how they did the floor for the digester wastewater drainage. For that particular situation, I also preach that you do have a slope leaving the biodigester bed. A slope from where the inlet pipes are leading slowly or giving it a gradient slowly to where the outlet is, which is the initial pipe. And the reason for this is because you do not want any water to be retained in the digester. In fact, you just don't want any water to be retained in the digester. And I have also liked the sharp slope just to get the water out immediately. You do flush, the wastewater comes into the digester so as to give it less moisture, so as to make it more dry. The more drier the chamber is, the better the biodegradation. Your worst enemy is the water. There's moist in the digester, then the biodegradation that is supposed to happen is not going to happen. So having the screeding done at the bottom is just to ensure that that water is taken out as soon as possible when the water comes with the human waste into the digester. Another key point that you need to know is the soakhole pit or the soakaway that you are designing for your digester. I've done latest videos on the new soakaway designs that I'm also implementing so as to save cost and still make sure the digester works to perfection. And that includes just doing just this simple soakaways that includes a few pieces of blocks just to make sure that the water has got a way to go out, and then the water or the digester leachate pipe is still protected from any outside debris that might come in, especially when you do the soakhole pit. Because the soakhole pit means that you are leaving the soakaway to the elements in the environment, and then you cannot control it. As much as possible, whenever you're constructing a biodigester, you want to control the elements that will not make the biodigester work for you. So your work is to make sure that anything that prevents the biodigester from working well, you eliminate it so that the biodigester can be used for a longer time. And then in case you are even caught, whenever you go to site for correction or maintenance, it's easy for you because you have actually done the work before coming, before the maintenance has been done. The better your biodigester is constructed, if there's an issue when you are caught, the better it is that you are able to solve the problem. So I always advise biodigester constructors as much as you are looking at the money or the cost involved or whatever you're taking for the digester, ensure that for you to have a business that lasts longer, you need to make sure the biodigester is working from day one, not through the correction, because the correction is not going to do much. When you are doing maintenance or you are doing a correction, the best bet is to only remove the digester bed or the materials that are on the digester bed out of the digester. You are not going to be able to change the how you have already constructed the biodigester. So your initial construction of the biodigester is key to making it work for you for a longer time. Another important thing that you must also note is when you are filling the biodigester bed with the porous slabs, there are sometimes that, let's say you are getting them out of sight and then you are coming to lay them in the digester bed. Sometimes you get the measurements wrong and then you go to the site before you have to do the chippings, or you have to cut some parts to make sure that it fits perfectly into the digester bed. Do not bother yourself breaking it, because then probably you might just get a porous or pervious concrete broken up. Just make sure that if there's only one side of it, you are putting it on top and it's just going to work fine. A mosquito net or fiber net is what separates the pervious concrete from the human waste. When you are doing maintenance, most of the time, this is what you lift. If it's not melted or it's not become weak, when it's time for you to do the maintenance, this is what you lift together with the solid waste. And then the fiber, the coconut fiber that's on it. Because then this separates it and makes it easier for you to get there. So you just tuck them neatly on either side of the biodigester bed, making sure that there's no holes around each corner of the digester bed. You want to bring the husk or the fiber on it so that you can equally cover every part of it. You do not want any debris or waste on the screening floor. If that happens, it's going to prevent the water from draining out of the digester, and eventually it's going to flood up to the top, and then the inlet pipe is going to be blocked. So you want to make sure that your fiber net or your mosquito net is stacked on each side of the biodigester bed. And then the biodegradation material, which is the most important part, comes in. This is what helps you make sure that the human waste is biodegraded. And then, people ask, how do you treat coconut fiber? In Ghana, we have machines, these specially constructed machines that breaks them into coconut coir or into the husk form for use by biodigester constructors. So I'm going to go to one of the sites and then see how it's being done. And then I might get a video just for you. So spread the coconut fiber on it evenly. Make sure each side gets its own, and then it's ready to receive the human waste whenever the need comes. You are also going to make sure that when you're putting the top slab on it, it's firm so that there are no holes by the side, and then it can, before you seal it, airtight with mortar. So in the long run, biodigester bed with prefabricated slabs makes it easy to have them located. It's not all houses that you might be able to use blocks. There are some specific situations where the slabs are your best bet, and the slabs equally work well when it's being done, and it's being done well, precast and it's firm. So in this situation, you do have your soakaway. It's a small size one. The land is good, so our soakaway works well. Our floor has been done. The screening has been done. Slope leading out of the digester bed, immediately water comes out, is gone. Inlet pipe has been fixed, waiting for the plumber to bring the pipe from the house into it. And then all the joints have been sealed with mortar and loose ends held up tightly. Biodigester construction shouldn't be anything difficult for anybody who wants to learn how to construct them. Make sure you follow all the steps, especially that these channels provide for you in the videos that we do have when it comes to biodigester construction. This is a channel that we have dedicated to the construction of biodigesters, strictly for those who want to learn how to construct a biodigester. It's also a channel for homeowners who want to know how this technology works, and then obviously adapt it as a means of managing their human waste. The sharp contrast is because then there's the obvious traditional system of managing human waste, and now obviously there's this new method of managing human waste, which in our part of the world seems to be one of the best options available, because the human waste do biodegrade and then it's easy for disposal in the environment. That's why this channel is on this network. So if you are new here, you can subscribe and follow us. The next video showing on this channel is going to explain to you how to construct a biodigester and construct it to perfection for your dream house.